Oh, I'm sick as shit. I know what I need.
We just gonna rock with it.
Well, once again, we've got one of these long ass intros.
Who fault it is, bro? Your shitty ass computer. That's what we gonna blame it on.
Ain't editing that out. I hope they destroy you in the comments. All 36 of our subscribers.
The cancellation tour already began. Began 2 episodes ago. Alright. Welcome back to the Ignorant Noodle. We have, as you can see, we got a very new guest today. State your name.
Kiana.
And,
Yeah, okay. Last episode, Black History Month. Final episode. We're going to start it off right. We're going to name this one. Bro, I'm going to name the Black Fan thing and all that. Just so I can force people to watch this.
You say that?
Oh. No, we ain't seen it. I'm just going to title this Black Fan thing and all that.
That's my book.
Yeah, trust me, they're going to click on this video.
Okay.
And once they hear this part, they're going to exit out. She has her own YouTube channel.
And so I'm going to take this Wild Growth Oil, shake it up as it says on the back.
She does makeup, not hair, makeup, hair. Hair and
it's
makeup.
It's beauty, yeah. It's a beauty channel.
I really be watching these beauty channels. I don't know what the fuck be going on. I just be watching.
Well, you can't say it's fake support.
Hey, boy, you about to get into it.
Nah, my throat was dry.
So, what made you start your YouTube channel? Because you just started, like.
I did. It was just something that I wanted to do, like watching other people do their channels and stuff. And it just, I don't know, it was kind of like a gradual process. Like, years of just thinking, like, oh, that would be so cool. And then one day I was like, I'm just going to do it. I just did it.
That's low-key how we started, bro. Right. We didn't have so many dumbass conversations. Everybody just said, bro, y'all niggas really need to record yourselves or be somewhere with this shit. And we just,
So, talk about... What you looking at, bro?
How that shit ain't moving, bro. Fuck it, bro. We just gonna use the video. We gonna use the camera audio again. Well, I'm sick of this shit.
Like, anywho. So, how long ago was your first video?
My first video was like 2 weeks ago.
Oh, so you fresh. Okay.
Yeah, I'm real fresh.
Okay.
Yeah, I see.
I only have like 2 videos though, but I'm trying to go like every week.
Swear to God, bro, I was like the fourth viewer of their shit.
Yeah.
Because it probably I was just like, alright.
But see, I had already talked to you about it though. That was like a month before I even put it. No, that was like December.
Oh, so she knew before, she was talking about it before she even made it happen.
Yeah.
Yeah, because what we said, I was like, fuck, we're going to make a YouTube. You came over the next weekend, I had microphones, cameras. Boy, that,
ain't that a bitch, though, but...
That well running dry.
But you recorded the first episode without me. Ain't that a bitch?
Well, you was taking forever, man. Like, yo.
Oh, go spend time with your family.
I ain't say that. Bro. You said you was about to go on the cruise or some shit.
No, bro, I said my mama had family coming into town.
Hell yeah.
And then you said, oh, go spend time with your family.
I was saying, I ain't gonna pull you from your family.
3 days later, the episode went up, bro. It be your own niggas, bro.
Like I said, bro, is we niggas, truly. I ain't never been that for you.
You were. Oh, that's fucked up, bro, because you pulled me out of my job to come take your ass to,
Nah, I just needed a companionship on that road trip.
Bro, and I was asleep halfway.
Yeah, you a bitch for that shit. And you made me pay you.
Bruh, you the one that said you... Alright, bruh. You didn't tell you didn't offer to pay?
Why would I offer to pay my homeboy to spend time with me?
Oh.
What kind of nigga you think I am?
Oh, all we niggas?
You think this guy plans, bruh? Out of here, nigga. You got $1 million budget.
I thought we had a topic we were staying on, bruh. I thought we were gonna do better on staying on topic.
We niggas. Hair. And black people and their hair. Cause some black people ain't got...
Don't look over here if you don't want to show it.
Black people and hair, black women in their hair, because this whole, the new natural movement is one of those things I love because I do like natural hair, but I'm sick of weaves. That shit ain't natural.
But see, and I knew it was going to happen. You can't, like, praise black women for being natural and then try to diss the ones who do weaves.
Like, no, it's not dissing the weaves. I understand that. It's those that's like, oh, I'm natural, but you've never actually seen their hair. They alternate from weave to wig to weave to wig to weave to wig. You're like, oh yeah, I've been natural 8 months. We've never seen that shit.
Being natural is hard work. Like, you don't understand. It's a lot.
All right, so define being natural. Because I
it's just no chemicals. That's all it is. So the wig and weave is still natural.
Yeah, but I'm saying like, yeah. I can hear how hard going natural is, but like, what is the process of going natural? So you thought I'm putting no chemical on it?
Shaving your hair looking like Eve, India Ari, and then growing it into Beyonce?
Or you can transition.
How long does that take? Like, if you shave your head off, like, to get it back?
Oh, get a temp fade? Oh, it don't take that long, bro.
Really?
Because shrinkage is real. So a girl be growing her shit, you see like a little mini fro.
Right, that's
and then she'll just like, oh, lint check, bitch. She'll snatch it and pull it down and be like, way down here. Like, oh, shit, all right. Are we blowing up today, huh?
Chill.
The holes are flocking.
It's our next guest. Anywho.
Damn, bro, you deleted the number?
I never saved it.
Well, I hope she don't watch this episode.
Oh, she don't fool me no way, so I'm sure she won't.
Alright. What did you say?
So how long, are you natural or?
Yeah, I'm natural. I've been natural. Oh my god, I've been natural for a long time. But see, you wouldn't be able to tell, like, looking at my hair. Like, everybody, it just grows different. Like, he says, shrinkage.
Shrinkage is real, bro.
Natural is a whole process.
Alright, so what's your favorite natural hairstyle? You just, the afro, or do you
want I love the fucking fro, bro. That curly fro, nappy fro, any fro. Boy, yeah. Froze, boy.
I don't do the fro, because it's a lot of work that goes into the fro, too.
See, I don't want to opposite end. I'm not really a fan of the fro. Only because, bruh.
What you said in the car over here, bruh? Curly hair just do something to
it? It do. But I'm not a fan of the afro, bruh. Because it is a lot of work, bruh. Back when I had it. You'll never know now. It's long gone, bruh. In the corporate world, they don't want that.
But. Oh, shit. Yeah, I had a girl that, I told her I love natural hair. I liked it. And she was just like, oh, it's just too much work. And then she's like, well, if you had to do it, you'd understand. And I offered to do it with her, and she still got mad at me. She just kept wearing wigs.
Huh. All right, so talk about...
Damn, bro.
You ain't got the address, bro?
It's in the bio, bro.
Damn shame. So how do you feel about being a black YouTuber? Do you feel like it's going to be...
Boy.
Some that's easily supportive, or do you feel like
gotta put in all the extra hashtags, bro, to make sure we get seen?
Just to make sure we get seen, bro. I know you're new to the YouTube world,
right?
But.
I mean, I don't know, because on my YouTube, I guess my viewers, like the other black people, you're only gonna see other black people. Like when I go on YouTube and I search them, I only see
because
I'm searching for topics that we talk about or we know. You know, mm-hmm. Ain't nothing to see no white girl looking up how to do pop swap.
And yet, I've seen it. That should be looking like,
Are we talking about those?
Oh, yeah, white girls in their fox life? Yeah.
That shit's awful.
Yeah.
You ever seen the Grinch, bro? That's what that shit looked like, bro.
Bro, I seen that shit. It's fingers. Because I know black YouTubers is much harder, but I also feel like as a black male YouTuber, it's much harder for example, women, like all of y'all are looking for beauty tips. So it's just certain codes that y'all already know to look for. Niggas ain't looking up all black talk shows. Niggas ain't looking up black podcasts. Niggas ain't looking for us.
Round you.
I'm professional as fuck, bruh. I'm professional as fuck.
Says the, oh, but you remember when we was back at the old studio and the phone was ringing the whole time? Oh, we wanna talk about that.
Nah, we ain't. Fuck you. Black excellence. This really is the dynamic of our show, bro. We randomly argue with each other. But as I was saying, it's so much harder for like black males. So I feel like at any moment a girl can say, oh my god, your hair's so pretty. You can just, here's my YouTube. That's
right,
how I did it.
Right.
We can't do that.
Nah, bro.
I gotta make a nigga laugh. Like, hey, you like these laughs? Check us out.
Nah, bro.
Check us out. Check these jokes.
I'm about to do a side hustle, black haircut tutorial, bro.
You said they just got the new mirror shit.
Yeah, nigga cutting their own shit now, bro. Good luck with that.
What? What mirror?
It's like a three-way mirror so you can see all sides of your head when you're cutting.
Oh, we kind of have that too, but with like makeup.
The vanity mirror?
Yeah.
I don't see why y'all got to see behind y'all ear when y'all doing makeup, but
it's not really behind. I mean, you need to see what you look like over here because you need to know that your highlight is on point, everything, you know what I'm saying? The end of your eyebrow, all of that. That's how it is.
See, that's the thing. I've never been a fan of makeup, bro. I really like the natural look. I'm not saying don't wear makeup because I understand women love their makeup. Don't cancel me. Cancel this nigga. You say don't wear makeup, women lose that shit. But, like, you can look at a girl and see when she has too much. Like, you're just like, I just know your face is hot under all that makeup because you can see it. And it's like, it don't look nice because you know what skin looks like. Mm-hmm. And then you know what powder looks like. You see it, and it's just like, nah.
Nah, it's... I'm not a fan of the makeup look only because people can transform themselves so quickly.
That's what I don't like about it.
Yeah, exactly.
You gotta look somewhat the same. Like, I understand if you take it off and I see acne scars, that's understandable. That's not, you don't want that to be seen. I understand. But if you look like two different people, like these couples that are getting married and they've never seen each other without makeup, and then like the wedding night.
Who doing that?
Bruh, there's a dude divorced his wife because he never saw her without makeup. He thought this is how she looked. She took her makeup off after the wedding night. Next day, he went and got that shit annulled.
I feel like I've seen this somewhere.
Yeah, that's just like the Asian couple that she had plastic surgery because apparently she was just butt ugly before. She had plastic surgery. Dude never knew. They had kids. The kid came out ugly. And the dude said, yo, what the fuck? Like, nah, my wife fine. Yo, where these kids come from? I know I'm not that ugly. And then he saw, like, child pictures of her, and he divorced her. He actually sued her.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yeah, because he was like, this isn't what I signed up for. He was like...
That's so trifling. How can you sue somebody
over that? Like, he didn't know his kid was going to be that ugly. She tricked him. She didn't show him no baby pictures, no childhood photos. I don't know what this nigga was thinking. He never saw a childhood photo of his girl. Hell, be happy she was just ugly. It wasn't a man.
That's what these ACL niggas doing. That's what you gotta do. You gotta make pictures.
Kick the throat.
Get all that.
Niggas are so charming.
Not at all.
Yeah.
Not at all. Yes. I'm just trying to figure out, bro, how do you get married to somebody you ain't never...
See, you never seen it. I ain't never seen... Hey, women go to sleep in that shit. Wake up before you put it on.
Are y'all sleeping in bed?
Nah.
That's what I'm saying, bro.
Lay back down. Oh, my God. Such a wonderful sleep. She been up 3 hours doing her makeup.
Now that is probably what she was doing. She probably been sleeping, but she probably got it real early and was like, you know.
So how she go to sleep? Did she wait for this nigga to fall asleep, take it off, go to sleep for 3-4 hours, wake back up, put it back on?
That's determination.
That's exhausting. Like, you don't get
tired. She went to sleep in the living room like this.
In the recliner room?
Yeah, had a paper towel under her chin so she ain't getting on her shirt.
Who she fooling, bro?
Obviously this nigga, bro.
That's too much work. That's too much work.
That is too much, yeah.
I was not.
So, on an average makeup tutorial, how long are you spending doing makeup? Like, how long? How long? Like, if you go into an event, how long are you spending doing your makeup?
If I'm doing, like, a full deal, like, highlighting contour, it takes a minute. Like, maybe about 45 minutes.
Oh, my God. That's too much time.
It took a long time. And
that ain't got shit to do with her clothes, her heels. If she changed her outfit, the makeup got to go too, bro.
Oh, bro. Nigga, be on the couch like this, bro. But don't let your shoes be off.
Yeah, let that nigga not have his shoes on when she ready. Oh my God, we're gonna be late. Like, yo, I know she ain't.
No, that's facts though.
You sitting there like,
we've been here for 2 hours waiting on you.
I showed up at 7, so it's 9. Well, hurry up, it's gonna end at 10.
Look, if she ain't ready till 9, that means you don't gotta start getting ready till 8:15, bro. If that.
Oh. Let you forget your key.
She be in the car ride having an attitude the whole way.
We late because of you.
Yo, bragging on the womanhood. Like, it's a lot to come into this.
No, it's not.
Yes, it is.
If I was sitting there and I said, hey, I'm trying to take you out right now. Let's go get something to eat. What you gonna say?
Okay, but that's a casual setting. But y'all talking about as far as makeup, get my heels. That's a whole nother setting. I gotta do everything.
Do you really though?
Do you really?
Because that made me feel, I mean, I don't know why everybody else do it, but I like dressing up because it just made me feel good. Like, I don't care about perception.
Let a man say, damn, baby, I like the way you look. Really? Let's go out. I'm trying to show you off. Let me get myself together. I just said I love the way you look. That's why a lot of niggas don't invite girls out. The whole come to my place for a date. It's because they don't want to wait.
I'm not meeting a woman at my house for the first date, bro.
Still, we got a new studio, bro. We got a guest, so we got a new studio.
Oh, that's the reason why you got a new studio, bro.
Yeah, because we was gonna be at CSU. I was looking at CSU to use those rooms. The owner of this establishment hit me up and was like, hey, you know, if you're trying to use a studio.
Oh, she slid you a good deal.
She really did. For the free ski.
Exactly.
If you want your taxes done, come down to OG Taxes, 3025 University Avenue, Suite C2. Go ahead and get that shameless plug in there, bro.
The last two episodes, you've been trying to get them off, bro. So why do you wear makeup?
Why do I wear makeup? Why do I wear makeup? I just like it. Like I said, I like the way it makes me feel good. I don't do like the whole transforming of my face thing, but I just like it.
Okay, we back behind, bro.
Yeah, I seen the moving again. I just don't like I've never liked makeup.
I haven't either, bro.
No, the ones that do the special effects, like shit like that, that's cool.
The special effects.
Yeah, like people actually do, like, they're like, oh, you know, zombie makeup, and they're showing, like, blood and shit.
Oh, have you seen that show? It's a show where they do that, like, competition-wise. It's cool.
Oh, yeah, it's on the Sci-Fi channel. I've seen that.
Oh, bro, I just seen some shit on Instagram where a nigga had a pencil coming out his mouth, bro.
Oh, yeah, like, they do that.
I was like, is this what y'all doing?
It's like a latex layer on their face already, and they, like, stick the pencil in between. So it's, like, jabbing them in the cheek, but it's still sticking out, so it just looks real. Yeah.
Yeah. It's
a lot that goes in, because like pretty much anytime you see somebody get stabbed in their face in a movie or something, pretty much they have their face, and then they have like maybe like 2-3 pounds of makeup on top of their face to look like their face just to stick something through.
Yeah, bro, that shit sound heavy.
Yeah, like they'll jab something on this side, and then I have something in between like the makeup and their cheek on the other side, so it looks like they just got stabbed in their shit. And they're pretty much holding something in their mouth. So it's like 3 pieces that they gotta hold perfectly still to look like they got stabbed through their mouth.
That's uncomfortable.
Yeah.
It's gonna be a hard no for me on that one. But,
No, I was gonna say, so y'all think you don't like makeup, but I guarantee that if you name a celebrity that you like.
Oh, no. I've already accepted that everybody's wearing makeup at all times unless they were just butt ugly. It's like, you just woke up.
But everybody has like a huge transformation. Where it's
yeah, I know, but I've accepted that all women are always wearing makeup.
Yep, it's like
yeah, I've accepted that. Yeah, I just accept that you're always wearing makeup. It's not even a she doesn't look like no. Even if she doesn't look like she's wearing it, unless you see all of her blemishes, like unless you know for a fact she just rolled out of bed, and even then it's questionable because some women are still I just rolled out of bed and I have like blush and highlights and all that shit. Just like your cheeks don't shine like that, baby. Mm-hmm. You ain't fooling me. So I just said that, like, women are always wearing makeup. Some wear less than others.
Yeah.
Because I seen a chick that I thought never wore makeup. Well, I just didn't think she wore that much makeup. Then I finally saw her without makeup. And I was just like, Okay. So you was wearing makeup pretty much every time I saw you. Like, yeah, I'll be at the pool, makeup on.
Wait, what?
Because so you're taking pictures at the pool, you know? You
that's why the ones that say don't throw me in, makeup.
No, hair. Hair is a
factor. I understand that, but y'all will really go crazy over the makeup because y'all don't want that shit running off. Like, you'll be pissed about your hair, but if it's a wig, like, you really ain't that pissed. Just like, fuck, I gotta do it. But if it's makeup, like, your face running down, you look like Two-Face. Now you're sitting there in the middle of the party like, bitch, I gotta go. Like,
oh my God.
Now you gotta run to the car, take it all off, and just like, I just gotta do something. Like, just keep your emergency kit. Keep your emergency kit in the trunk.
Niggas will see you at the party with the shit melting. You can't come back from that, bro. You can go home.
Y'all talking about a whole other class of women, like.
Because you know, which one of your friends then did it?
No, not my friends. I'm talking about some of them. You know, you got them girls who just.
Acquaintances. She thought of at least 2 people.
She has some names ready. She has some names ready.
Yeah,
come on, that show insulted us. We is stupid.
Cancellation tour, bro.
You really want to get canceled?
Yeah, that's what we call me. All 3 these episodes. Cancellation tour.
Little Charlemagne. Back into colorism. Speaking of Charlemagne and having his bleaching of his skin, because niggas.
Wait, he did it?
They still say it. Charlemagne ain't confirmed or well, he keeps denying. But it's one of those like we've seen the pictures, like we've seen what it looks like, and he says because he just started drinking water. He said he learned beauty tips. That's Charlamagne's excuse. He said, I started drinking water and I started exfoliating. That's the big difference. And there's one who's, I understand. I understand. But that was like, Charlamagne, you was 3 different tones of black. Hey, bro, you ain't gonna look at me. That's your role model.
You call whatever you want to hate Susan. But
I'm trying to be like DJ Envy, bro. What a butt plugs and vibrators at?
Anywho, bro, water and exfoliation taking you. How white?
But they say if your skin is just that, like, if it's really that dirty, like, that, it really can't do that. Like, that's what I'm saying. I'm not knocking Charlemagne, but it's one of those, like, if you put 2 pieces on, like, that's a little bit more than water, bro.
I need to see the evidence. I didn't see.
Go ahead and keep talking, bro. I got this.
Damn, bro. But I mean, skin bleaching, bro. Like, that's what people want to do. Like, it's something I could never do.
Lark Voorhees.
She fucked her whole face up, bro.
Lil Kim.
That shit. Hold on. I'm glad you just said that, bro.
But Lil Kim came out and said that she hated herself.
Yes, but if she said she hated herself because she was a side chick to Biggie and how he treated her doing all that. But at what point is she gonna hold some self accountability? Like, you can't fuck up your face and then come back in there and blame somebody else. Exactly.
Yeah. But you typed in Charlamagne before and it already has before and after skin.
Okay, that's not a huge difference.
Shit. That's probably the still more recent dark skin. I mean, you have to think about,
like flashes and everything.
But that's the thing, they said that there's multiple pictures of old Charlamagne just being dark and different colors and all this, like two-tone, three-tone, all this.
Yeah, you can see on this picture right here, he's like, he has a dark, I mean, he said he liked some beauty products.
That's what I'm saying, they said somebody just came in and told him like, hey, drink water, exfoliate, use these products, and they got them right. But people just, they say it's too much self-hate because of how reckless Charlamagne talks. They say it's a colorism thing, like when he did the interview with Amara La Negra, I think that's her name.
They
said he was going in, and they're like, he's playing dumb as fuck. Like, he doesn't understand colorism. They're like, nigga, like, you out here going from, you know, fucking black as shit to white as hell. You act like you don't understand colorism. And it's one of those things, like, every now and then they let it die down. But then Charlamagne says something just like, nigga, you bleach your skin, shut the fuck up.
I mean, he's been nice though, man.
And that's the thing, is one of they say Charlamagne is a strong advocate for self-hate, but he's always trying to get other people to talk about confidence shit. And it's just, like, I'm trying to feel like, I feel like it stopped being about his skin tone a long time ago. I think they just hate Charlamagne. And if this nigga did get healthy skin, it's just like, nah, nigga, self-hate.
I like Charlamagne, though. You ain't gonna stick up for your boy?
Nah, not on this topic, because I didn't see the proof, bro. I'm in the category of the nigga with skin bleaching.
And that's the thing, because if you may not, you don't know him, but this nigga drinks water all the fucking time. Nigga's still dark skinned, so.
Yeah.
That's
I
why.
Said,
that's
I said two tone, bro.
That's what I'm saying. That's why he's sitting on this side, like, Charlamagne, you have the. I mean, like, if you look at, like, what was that, our second, third picture on Instagram? Of you and your water supply?
Exactly, bro.
All this shit, hold on, bro.
This is not the topic he gonna have my support on, bro, because. And being dark skinned, being darker than everybody else, bro. You know, I got all the jokes, you know, and then my shit two tone now.
That's all his water.
I'm trying to get like this.
Skin bleaching has just never been a thought for me. Like, right. That's not something that I would ever even think about doing. So it's
just
so,
like,
so until he come out and say he really did get it like this, okay. Then maybe I'll throw my two cents his way.
Yeah.
But other than that, it's a no for me on that.
Trademark it. It's a no for me.
So I think somebody already beat me to it, bro.
They trademarked it?
Hell yeah.
I hope not. Nigga, you say it way too much.
Who they gonna collect it from?
You right.
Exactly.
Shit, you better hit him with the 50 cent. Tell him you poor. Find out you got like 6 million bitcoins saved up somewhere.
Nah, bro. But my name is getting trademarked, though.
Whatever you want to call me?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, I'm working on trademarking the ignorant noodle, bro. It's gonna be like $225. You putting in on that?
Taking out my next shake, bro. Anywho,
boy, you ain't never gonna get paid all the shit you owe me for putting into this business. Cause you help me out on a personal tip. You be looking out for me. You feed me every now and then. You feed the fam. I respect that. Speaking of which, are we getting sharks after this?
We can, bro. We can.
All right. Look, she's like, I might stick around.
Gonna be a long wait.
What, she texts back? But on the whole colorism thing, has there ever been any issues, like, obviously all black people, we've seen racism, but has there ever been some straight up colorism shit that you've experienced and you're just sitting there like, I ain't about to deal with it?
It's all the time. I remember, matter of fact, the other day, I swear, and this dude, he's like, oh, you're so beautiful, you know, all this. I'm like, thank you.
He said you pretty for a dark skin?
I was like, you slipping in there?
He did. So he's like, I just love me a dark skinned woman. I was like, all right, you know. He's like, you know, light skinned women pretty, but I love me a dark skin. I had to tell him, like, we all just beautiful, you know what I'm saying?
And low key, I know what he's saying, because I do love my chocolate women. But I'm not about to go talking to somebody like, yo, light skins are cute, but I'm really, like, nigga, you're trying too hard to get her attention.
Like, it's one thing to have a preference, but as far as, like, splitting the line, like, we all just black, you know?
Because I get a homeboy like that. Nigga, his whole ideal woman, we're gonna hit this in, next two subjects. But he always said, like, pretty much everything he described as his ideal woman, his girl is nothing like that.
Everything like that.
And he's sort of like, this is the perfect woman for me. I'm like, but you've never dated a woman that looked like that. His is tall, long legs, light skin, curly hair. All his women are like short and dark skin. I'm just like, bro, if you like dark skin women, just say that. Like, why do you create this idea of a woman? You just never date that person.
But, besides that term, oh, you pretty for dark skin, that shit.
Bro, is it?
That we got.
Anytime you say you pretty 4A, like, just cut it.
Yeah, somebody really wrote that in my yearbook, too. So now every time I wrote my yearbook.
Bro, the disrespect. Yo, what that nigga name is?
No, this was a girl.
What her name is?
She was like brown skin. I don't know. What was her name?
Hey, fuck you. I got you, girl.
Shit pitiful, bro. Shit piss poor, bro.
Know what I'm saying? Because, I mean, it's a lot, like with Lil' Kim, it's a lot of self-hate and colorism. I feel like one of the fucked up things is the idea of calling when you don't find somebody attractive. Like, if somebody says a light-skinned girl ain't that attractive, like, man, she ain't all that cute. Dark-skinned girl ain't attractive, all of a sudden she's a fucking rope. So, like, why the fuck? Like, why do we start with that?
Shit, that's how they did Lupita when she first came out. She was ugly as hell. Black Panther then came
out. Oh, yeah. I love me a short hair, dark skin queen, blah, blah, blah.
I hate you niggas so much. God damn, I hate
bruh,
you.
Bro, niggas piss me off. Man, like,
that's my next video, by the way.
How you a beauty? She doing a beauty blog talking shit about niggas.
Advice of life, okay? See how all that time is? I'm doing a tell-all video.
She curling her hair, telling niggas they ain't shit. Let a nigga say some shit about this. Fuck you. Your niggas ain't shit. I'm not pretty for dark skin. I'm just pretty, bitch.
Bro, if a nigga say anything, bro, they
ain't in the comments, shit. Bro. I'll be lurking, bro. Don't worry, I got your back. I'll be sitting in the comments waiting. Fuck, nigga. Keyboard warrior. Hey, just put me in all your videos in the corner just like this. I'll do that shit.
All right, so I'm going to throw some names out for you, and I want you to give me your thoughts on them.
Oh, God, okay.
I know, right?
Do you know who Dave East is, the rapper?
Yes.
Oh, we getting on the male side?
Boy. I'm about to bring it all the way around. Are you fine?
Yeah.
Okay. What about Kodak Black?
Yeah.
He fine?
Mm.
Let's see.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What about Daniel Kaluuya?
What's that?
Chris from Get Out.
The nigga from Get Out.
Oh, yeah. Right.
Just alright?
Yeah, yeah.
Right. Chris Brown.
Chris Brown, alright.
Drake.
Drake from
Meek Mill.
Oh, no, Meek
Mill. Let us take a friend.
It's fine as well. Omar Epps back in the 90s. Oh my God.
They didn't look the same.
Can we get a mop? I think it was an accident in the studio.
No, he did not look the same.
I'm telling you, that nigga became head coach for the Steelers. He ain't looked the same since.
Omar Epps did.
Nah, the Steelers head coaches looks like Omar Epps, so everybody just calls
Omar
him.
Omar Epps
really do. He
looked like he was been on like Crackers and he just mad old, but he back in the day.
So we ain't talking about
Loving Basketball.
Love Basketball Juice. When he was said that
Juice.
Loving Basketball trash as hell, boy. But keep going. That was trash as hell.
No, it's not.
Hey, chill, bro. She got on a hat with basketball on it, so you know.
Right, you gotta have respect for Loving Basketball.
I don't.
How many niggas have you told you're gonna play for their heart?
No.
Bruh, that shit was cringe, bruh. That shit, let me play for your heart. This nigga about to get married tomorrow.
See, I think
what
it's
the
more
fuck?
Like a chick flick. Maybe
like all the parodies that came out, all the YouTube videos. Let's play for your heart, niggas dunking on that girl.
That song fire, though.
Which one?
That.
Ain't no better basketball soundtrack than Blue Chips.
Never seen the movie.
It's a nigga in Afghanistan put me on it. He said all he watched was basketball movies. It's a movie with Shaq and other shit. The mother niggas.
Oh, you selling me on Shaq? On Shaq acting, bro?
Boy, Steel was amazing. Shazam, all that. even though we all know it was Sinbad originally.
Bro, you the same.
And then the Bear Sting Bears theory shit.
Bro, you the same nigga that tried to tell me Will Smith was the GOAT actor, bro. You see how
that Will Smith's right up there with Denzel, bro.
No, oh, no, he's not, bro.
He's pretty good, though. He plays parts.
He's not at all. It's Denzel, Jamie Foxx down here.
We're gonna say that for another video, bro, because you feel passionately about that.
All right. This has been the Ignorant Noodle on colorism. Stay tuned for whatever happens next.
Listen. I'm a few hundred thousand short of an AP, but no less presidential. Tryna climb me for a drive in a Honda while they pushing a rental.